Good afternoon, good afternoon. Buenas tardes. Happy graduation day. We are getting ready to welcome our class of 2023, and we would ask everyone to please rise as the class enters. Welcome. Please remain standing for the presentation of colors, the Star Spangled Banner, and lift every voice and sing. Thank you. Please be seated. And let's please show our appreciation to the Czech band, the Czech NJROTC, Abraham Elizalde, and Jano Simonis for the wonderful opening. And now, let us welcome the 186 members of the resilient, the talented, the multicultural, and dynamic class of 2023. This is such a happy day, class of 2023. This is the day. In the words of the Czech Creed, you have shown that you are powerful beyond all measure. Class of 2023, do you realize how powerful you really are? Let's just share some of your accomplishments. You have completed every requirement in front of you, from portfolios to exams, to essays, to community service, to internships, and many of you are working at the same time. So give yourselves a round of applause. Before us, we have students who have shown grit and pride in sports, in the arts, in clubs, and community service. You have taken a total of 680 advanced placement exams, which shows you are ready for the rigor of college and careers. 86% of the class of 2023 applied to two or more colleges. That is truly outstanding. 82% were accepted to at least one college. And the colleges you will be attending are Ivy League, HBCU, international universities, and local colleges. You will be traveling all over the country and even the world to pursue your academic dreams. The class of 2023 so far has acquired more than $5 million in financial aid and scholarships. And the scholarships are still coming in. Many of you are making history by being the first in your families to attend college. Yes, give yourselves a round of applause and your families. The class of 2023 is a class of leaders. Each in your own unique way has contributed to making our school a better place. This year, you gave your voice and your ideas on how to improve and redesign our school. Because of your involvement, I'm really excited to announce that Czech has been selected to receive a grant as an XQ Redesign High School for school year 23-24, and that is due to you. That is your legacy. You have accomplished all of the above after spending the first year and a half of your high school career in virtual instruction. This is what it means to be powerful. Your power emanates from your family and community, however, who have stood beside you all these years. Parents and family members, I know you're so proud and happy that you have been the wind beneath the wings of your children. You have made great sacrifices so that their future can be brighter. So at this time, let's please show our love to our family and community members who have supported us all these years. We are a team of students, families, and faculty, and today is only possible because Czech has the most dedicated, the most talented teachers, counselors, administrators, and educators in the world. So class of 2023, I'm sure at times we may have gotten on your nerves, but I know that every graduate here can name several teachers or coaches who've been their mentor and support over the years. We, the teachers and staff, have an unwavering belief and love for each and every one of you. So if we could have our whole staff and administrators please stand so class of 2023 can show their appreciation and love and shout out the name of those people that have been your support. Thank you to our entire staff and faculty. It is now my pleasure to introduce Juliana Lopez Aguilar, valedictorian, and Andrew Mason, salutatorian of the class of 2023. They will be your masters of ceremonies for today's event. They are both outstanding students of Columbia Heights Educational Campus. I have the honor to tell you more about Juliana Lopez Aguilar. She is graduating with a grade point average of 4.35. Juliana is a member of the National Honor Society and has been on the Principal's Honor Roll all advisories all 4 years of high school. She has participated in dual enrollment at Montgomery College and is an advanced placement scholar, having taken 11 AP courses. And these courses span the range of all disciplines: AP Spanish Language, AP Psychology, Spanish Literature, English Language, Capstone Seminar, Biology, Calculus, Capstone Research, AP US History, and AP US Government. Yeah, that's right. In addition to her academic accomplishments, her leadership experiences include serving as a member of the Chancellor's Student Cabinet and a student representative to the State Board of Education. She's also served as an advocate to the Young Women's Project. Her extracurriculars include softball, and she received runner-up honors in her junior year, as well as All-League honors and the Batters Up Award. For her extensive community service, Juliana received the Silent Servant Award. Juliana had 5 Ivy League college acceptances and has chosen to attend Princeton University on a full scholarship. She will study public policy and Latin American studies with a focus on obtaining a certificate in teacher preparation. Juliana is a leader and a compassionate and exemplary student. She has made so many contributions to our school, and I'm thrilled that she is considering the field of education, as she will certainly be an amazing future educator. Please welcome your valedictorian, Juliana Lopez Aguilar.
Okay. Esta es Check Radio 3101 y bienvenidos al noticiero de la tarde. En las normas de la semana, por favor, asegúrense de mostrar empatía y respeto mientras escuchan a los oradores de hoy. La norma de la semana es mostrar empatía y respeto. I told myself today was the day. I'd stand here, pretend to make eye contact, stare at the ceiling of this room, and suddenly my fear would dissipate. Articles online told me, be confident and practice your speech. But TikTok told me to imagine the crowd in their underwear to stop being nervous. And that's easier, so I listened. But maybe I shouldn't have, because I'm imagining that now, and I am no longer in fear of public speaking, but instead in fear of not being able to forget this unforgettable picture. The underwear opening has already been used in other speeches. So am I totally ripping other people off for it by using it? Is this okay? Am I being authentic and original? Is this plagiarism? No. I must reinvent it. Good afternoon and welcome, distinguished platform guests, council members, Dr. Elliott, our commencement speaker, Ms. Nava, members of the school board, Czech faculty, and fellow class of 2023. I am currently shaking with nervousness, and I am also Juliana Lopez. I am the girl who cried over an IXL lesson in my ninth grade year because I could not get to 80% to finish my geometry assignment. Please, feel free to laugh with me or at me. If you don't get my jokes, just laugh at me and I will pretend like you're laughing with me. It's okay. I know, they're terrible. We did it. We made it. We are grown. Class of 2023 really likes that line. We are all now heading into college or on the path to be electricians or mechanics. My English major is out there. Let me just say, it's time to get lit and turn the page onto the next chapter on our lives. For my chemistry majors out there, you are all now in your element and ready to take on the world. For my math majors out there, take this speech as a sign of something good that is yet to come for you all. Please, just laugh at me. And to be clear, I am not crying up here. I'm just trying to keep my laughing, keep it professional. But for whatever path you are heading into, remember to do everything with originality, creativity. Don't just repost like we do on social media. I aspire to one day teach, and I am aware that there are millions of teachers out there, but I will do everything I can to make the most amazing and unique memories with my students and ignite that flame for learning that we all need to succeed. And in the same way, we should all try to stand out in our own paths. Senior year was definitely a year. Let me tell you, I cried. I laughed. I cried because I laughed. I worried. I worried some more. And I worried because I worried and I didn't want to worry. But I made it. We made it. The great class of 2023. But before I continue, please take a deep breath with me. The underwear method is not working and I am still shaking nervously. Hace 10 años, I arrived in the US without a sound of English, worried whether I would fit in or if I would ever have the opportunity to go to college. As naive as I was as a third grader, I knew that I was at a disadvantage. Slowly, I realized not having the special green card people talked about would bring me some obstacles. In a couple of years, I realized if I wanted to go to college, I would need a full ride. And so, I began my journey. Soon, the girl who did not speak any English learned several years worth of English in 1 year. Soon, the girl who did not know a sound of English knew almost all the songs to Hamilton the musical and memorized the entry song to it by heart. Soon, this girl would defy the odds and thrive with the rest of her fellow 2023 classmates. Fellow classmates? Fellow classmates, let's come back to reality now and stop dozing off. I know this was long. It's our time to listen. If you did not like my jokes, that's okay. Feel free to voice that. I know that you all will. That is one thing I love from our class. We speak when we know is needed, no matter how uncomfortable it seems. If I have learned anything from this class, is that we are prime examples of resilience and motivation to keep going. We have thrived and risen amongst challenges. So, class of 2023, remember to continue to be outspoken. Remember to advocate for ourselves and our community. go and conduct research on the resources minorities need, educate others about the importance of fostering healthy relationships, protest, testify, and assemble to disrupt the oppressive cycles in our communities. Continue to break the educational, generational chains in our families. Continue to be our authentic advocational selves. Continue to take what has already been done and do it even better. Do it in our unique way. And amongst all challenges and times when it seems like it is the end of the world, remember, everything will be okay. One way or another. In the wise words of the beloved Pitbull, life is to live it, not to let it live you. So, as Czech has ingrained in our brains and in our hearts, stand up and remember, if it is to be, it is up to me. And remind yourself, I will be the change I want to see. Y mientras llego al cierre desde el largo discurso, me gustaría darle las gracias a todos los que están presentes y a los que no están. Thank you to everyone who has been a part of our journey, and thank you in advance to those of you who have yet to be a part of it. Thank you to the admin team. Okay. Thank you to the admin team, the college and career team, to the custodial staff, the counselors, coaches, teachers, and families, and everyone who has served as a role model for the class of 2023, supporting each and every single one of us along the way. Gracias. Gracias a los padres de familia, amigos, y a las personas que han estado junto a nosotros durante los momentos fáciles y los momentos difíciles. I would like to give a special thanks, of course, to my family. So, le quiero dar unas gracias muy especiales a mi familia, en especialmente a mis padres, a mi mamá, a mi papá, a mi hermano, a mi hermana, y a todos los que me están acompañando aquí por estar conmigo en los momentos terribles y difíciles, y también por los fáciles. Por sus sacrificios y por todo lo que han hecho por mí, para que yo esté parada aquí haciendo esto. Of course, I cannot forget special thanks to my teachers as well, Ms. Takeva being one of my role models, Mr. Talarico, Mr. Connor, Ms. Walther, Dr. Iraeta, Mr. Abusaba Lopez, Mr. Cohen, Ms. McCulloch, Mr. McGee, and the list can go on and on. So thank you. And lastly, thank you to my third grade teachers, Ms. Pierre and Mr. Lopez, for believing in me the moment I set foot on this land of dreams. And in the same way that they planted the seed for education within me, I want to continue to plant many seeds in other children's hearts. On behalf of the class of 2023, thank you, Columbia Heights Educational Campus, for the last four memorable years of our lives. Now, as you leave today, class of 2023, or I should say, as we leave today, class of 2023, let's remember to be original. Let's remember that we do not need to reinvent the wheel. Instead, we can take that as a part of something bigger and make something even better than that. Y para la cita del día, felicidades clase de 2023. Gracias por escuchar a su anfitriona Juliana López en Radio Check 3101. Que tengan un buen resto de su día y un viaje seguro de regreso a casa. We will now have a musical selection performed by another outstanding Czech senior, Zariah Bailey. Zariah is a talented performer who has participated in our heritage assemblies with dance and vocal performances, and also is the leader of our Czech dance team. Zariah will be attending Georgia State University. Today, she will perform I Believe by Fantasia. Please welcome Zariah Bailey.
Dreams before, now I'm finally realized.
Thank you, Zariah Bailey, for that amazing musical performance. It is now my honor to present my dearest classmate, the salutatorian of the class of 2023, Andrew Mason. Andrew has a 4.27 grade point average and has been on the principal's honor roll for all 4 years. He has taken 9 advanced placement courses: AP English Language, AP English Literature, AP Psychology, AP Calculus, AP US Government, AP Capstone Seminar, AP Studio Art, and AP Biology. In addition to excelling in academics, Andrew is an accomplished musician. As Czech band member and band librarian, Andrew played the trombone with the Czech band for the past 4 years. He also was a producer with the musicianship in 2021 and a Blues Alley Youth Orchestra trombonist in 2021 through 2022. In the area of service, Andrew served as a youth leader for the Washington Ethical Society from 2019 to 2021, and as a green ambassador for the Washington Youth Garden in the summer of 2022. Andrew will be attending the Pennsylvania State University to major in psychology. Please welcome our class of 2023 salutatorian Andrew Mason.
This thing on? Okay. I'm working on it. Distinguished guests, teachers, friends, family, and of course, the class of 2023. I cannot express enough how honored I am to be up here addressing you all today. It's been a long year of hard work, stress, and action, sleepless nights and restless days thrown into the mix of what seems like an endless procession of educational commitments. But I'm here to reassure you all today that yes, you are in fact walking across this stage, away from high school into the rest of your life, where you'll still be working, but this time, you'll be getting paid for it. I want to start this speech off today with a confession. My fellow graduates and my family, currently watching me with somewhat worried looks on their faces, my confession is that I only got around to writing this thing like 2 days ago. It is quite literally my graduation, and I still procrastinated to the last minute. And as I stand to this stage, I am currently held up by the hope that number one, passed me right over to speech a couple times before today, and number two, even if I didn't, everything is probably going to be okay. The problem was that I didn't have too much going on, or even that I was being intentionally lazy. I just didn't know what to write the speech about. I had options of writing a basic speech that congratulated everyone and call it a day, or trying to be special and writing a speech that would make people laugh, and so many other choices for a speech across the board, and only one that I would end up giving today. I couldn't decide what to go with. It was like I was floating from idea to idea, never really deciding on anything, and therefore not seeing as much progress as I had anticipated making. During my time here at Bell, I've had an experience that is all around pretty similar to the problem in my speech. I didn't have a particular sense of direction, and so rather than directly committing to anything, I just tried to do everything all at once. I joined the band, I tried track for a month and then basketball for less than a week, I tried to pack my schedule full of classes I didn't particularly need to graduate, and I tried signing up for a bunch of extra activities I didn't really have the time or energy for, all in an effort to find a goal and a passion to set my direction for. The issue I was facing was this. In a very goal-oriented school, I didn't really have a particular goal that I wanted to fulfill. I think many of us can relate to this, especially from this year. constantly being asked where we were going after school, what we wanted to do, what we wanted to major in, why we were taking a gap year instead of going right to school, why we were doing this instead of that, all things you were somehow expected to have answers for. And don't get me wrong, when I didn't have an answer for those things, I wasn't judged or ridiculed. The people asking these questions were usually very understanding. But I think I, and many of my fellow graduates, convinced ourselves that we needed to have a purpose set in mind for when we move on, and have a plan and a path set out for us so we could simply walk down the easy lane. If you related to any of what I just said, if you don't have a particular major you want to study yet or career you wanted to pursue, and you're feeling some sort of anxiety over it, I'm here to tell you, you're doing great, and you're on the exact right track to finding that out. While you're all struggling to submit applications and secure grades, we forgot the greatest thing about graduation, that we're free to do our own thing. Our job here is done. When you walk across this stage today and leave this wonderfully decorated stadium with your family and friends, you can go out for dinner and rest easy that you do not, in fact, have that English essay due at Sunday at 11:59 p.m. There are no AP tests coming up, there are no fire drills to interrupt you, and there is no Mr. Jones telling you to get out the hallway. And there is nothing holding you back from finding out what you want to do. These years after high school aren't for walking the path to your career, they're for finding the entrance. It's okay not to have a particular direction or goal. In fact, it's fantastic. Not having a set path for your life means that every single path is a possibility. And as a brand new high school graduate, you get to decide which direction to take. Look, the speech had to get corny and inspirational at some point. I feel like I've let you guys off easy for the most part. My point is, for the past decade, we've all been sitting in school, learning how to be people under the guidance of our wonderful teachers and staff. And now that we're finishing up this year, we can finally figure out what it means to be our own person, with our own passions and our own goals, without having to write them down on Summit Learning. We don't need an advisory period to get our lives together, because we are the advisors now. Class of 2023, when you walk across the stage today, know that you aren't just going to the next chapter of your life, you're going to write it. Whoa, that voice cracked. Because from now on, you decide what you're going to do. And my fellow graduates, we've got nothing but time to decide what that means for each and every one of us. I think I speak for all of us when I say that I'll never forget the dedication, love, and support that we received here. And now it's time for all of us to use the support to do the next big thing, whatever we choose it to be. And with that, I say thank you, class of 2023, and congratulations. It is now my distinct pleasure to introduce a musical selection performed by the outstanding Czech Wind Ensemble, of which I'm a part of. Directed by Dr. Amelia Barnett, we will perform Can't Hold Us by Macklemore. And now I gotta run.
It is now another great pleasure to introduce the student government president, Isaac Fuentes. Isaac is graduating with a 3.89 GPA and has taken 4 AP courses: AP English Language, AP English Literature, AP Calculus, and of course, we can't forget his all-time favorite, AP Studio Art. Isaac is a member of the National Honor Society and has served on student government for the past 2 years and has been an active member of the XQ redesign team. He also was a member of the Czech band for 5 years. His community service includes serving as an assistant teacher at Wise Little Owls, a child development center. Isaac will be attending the University of Wisconsin at Madison as a Posse Scholar with a full 4-year scholarship. Now, please welcome one of our amazing students, Isaac Fuentes, who will bring greetings on behalf of the student government and introduce our commencement speaker.
Wow, there are a lot of people in here. All right, let's do this one last time. Good afternoon, teachers, staff, Ms. Dukeva, family, friends, my mom, hi mom. And of course, the bewildering class of 2023. How's everyone feeling? Sorry, I couldn't hear that. What's up? Do that one more time. There we go. Awesome. I'm happy to hear that because guess what? We made it. We have officially crossed the first finish line in the path of becoming great. And I can say with pride that I wouldn't have wanted it any other way. For those who don't know me, hello. My name is Isaac Fuentes. I'm a simple kid from Colombia who's willing to climb mountains to reach his goals. I'm the president of the SGA, a band student led by the lovely Dr. Barnett, a photography student taught by the fantastic Ms. McCulloch, and an overall pretty decent student. Coming this fall, I will attend the University of Wisconsin-Madison on a full Posse scholarship. And I plan to use this opportunity to follow in the footsteps of my idols, like my mom, Ms. Shaw, Ms. McCulloch, Dr. Barnett, Ms. Swift, Mr. Tallarico, and so many more. I'm going to become an art teacher. I want to spread the knowledge that I was given while also providing kids a home away from home like the one that I was also given. To be able to acquire all of this, I had to put my 100% into the things that I wanted, but I couldn't have done it without the amazing people around me. So with that said, I would like to introduce you all to a very, very special person. A person who helps people in need and makes sure they are safe. A person who, most of all, helps kids like me reach their full potential. But first, some fun facts, why not? Miss Cindy Nava is what you would call a fighter, a person that never gives into a plan not going her way. She believes in strengthening voices through civic engagement, education, and holistic methods rooted in transformative leadership. Practices that guide the creation of new policies and that support underserved communities across the country. As a former DACA recipient, Ms. Nava has focused on opening access for immigrants interested in politics to begin a pathway in leadership development and training that creates opportunities for them to serve within those sectors. Ms. Nava marked a historical moment, becoming the first undocumented person to intern for a national political party in Washington, D.C., and the first DACA recipient to work as a majority poll analyst for the New Mexico House of Representatives. Ms. Nava served as a political director for the U.S. Senator Ben Ray Lujan and as chief administrative officer in the United Hispanic Leadership Institute in Chicago, Illinois. Ms. Nava served as Executive Director to Transform Education New Mexico from 2021 to 2022, and most recently obtained an unprecedented White House presidential appointment, making her the first former DACA recipient in the United States to become a political appointee. Now, it is without my further ado, I'd like to present you all to the one, the only, Miss Cindy Nava.
The end. Is that what you asked? I'm not gonna sing, I'm sorry. You know, I could start like everyone else. I do need to say thank you, though. Thank you, District of Columbia Public Schools, Columbia Heights Education Campus, Principal Takiva, Mr. Whitney, faculty and staff, and parents. But I'm here for you, graduates. I have a whole speech laid out, but I'm about to just jump it. You have a choice, all of you who are here. You can choose to listen or stay on your phone, talk to your friends, not pay attention, who cares? It's up to you. I'm not here to beg you for attention because I don't come from anything, but I've learned the hard way. So you choose. Being undocumented was not easy in any way, shape, or form. And guess what? I didn't get to choose that. My parents came here from Mexico in 1997. And growing up without a social security number was one hell of a challenge. You see, celebrations are great. Achievements are monumental. However, I absolutely believe that if we don't speak about the hardships and the difficult moments in our lives, then all the wins are worthless. Graduates, let's be honest. You made it here. Your fellow classmates told you you were optimistic. They reminded you of the fact that you're here and you're going to go do great things. But I want to know, in all reality, I want you to raise your hand if you were ever told you weren't going to make it, and in the audience as well. I mean, let's be honest. Raise your hand if you were ever told you weren't going to make it. I mean, I was told many times. How many of you ever doubted yourselves? Raise both hands. Yep. And who was ever told that you were not good enough? Look, I wish I could tell you differently, but I'm just going to be real. Even within my own family, I heard I wasn't going to make it. I grew up with a whole lot of shame. A whole lot of shame because of my language, my culture, and where I came from. That was wrong. And it wasn't until the moment that I realized the strength in my language, my culture, and the communities that I represent, that's when my life changed. And as communities of color, we are the future, regardless of who tells you different. And we win more by partnering up. En el momento en el que aprendí el valor de mi lenguaje y el valor de los sacrificios de mis padres, me cambió la vida. So now that I've confessed my realities, I'll tell you. My name is Cindy Nava, and I am the proud daughter of a hardworking construction worker and a maid. Thank you. Two individuals who will never have the opportunity to stand on the stages that I get to, that I'm privileged to stand upon. And I asked you all if you have ever doubted yourself and if others have ever doubted you, because throughout my life, I heard it left and right. Cindy, you can't do that. Cindy, you don't have papers. Cindy, you're poor. Cindy, you live in an apartment complex. What are you going to do in life? Well, y'all, let me tell you. I grew up in apartment to apartment, moving day in and day out because my parents were in a constant search for jobs. Being undocumented, you've got to find jobs, and it's not easy. My life has been a collection of impossible dreams. Furthermore, a set of unattainable goals. A life of being questioned and argued. In high school, Jesus Christ, okay? Amen to you all. Bravo. Because that's tough. That's tough. Seriously, applause. I'm dead serious. You see, I want to ask you, truly, what grounds you? Why are you even here? Are you here because you were pushed to finish high school? Or because you have dreams and goals that you want to accomplish? How many of you are going to be the first in your family to go to college? Raise your hand. Raise your hand. Loud and proud. No, higher. All right, let's do it over. Hold on. No. ¿Qué es eso? How many of you are the first in your family to go to college? Raise your hand. Loud and proud. Más recio. ¡Qué bárbaros! No. Okay, all right, so we got a group of shy people here. That's fine. It's all right. It's good. All right. I want you to think of who and what grounds you. What values are you going to carry forward? For me, it started with my grandmother, who I called Yaya, my dad's mom. You see, my grandmother loved to read, avid reader with a third grade education. And again, because I was undocumented, I could never travel to Mexico. And my grandmother got very ill in 2016. By 2016, I had acquired DACA, Deferred Action for Early Childhood Arrivals, that granted me the opportunity to have a social security number. One day they called my dad and told him that my yaya was hospitalized. I went back to Mexico in 2016 with DACA after not being back since 1997, a country that was not my own, according to the people when I got there, because they called me gringa, which I'm not. I spent 15 days besides my yaya, only to watch her take her last breath. And that's hard. But you know what? This thing that I'm purposely wearing here, so that you guys see it, this was my yaya's. I know. And her third grade education gave me the values and the strength and the wisdom to know that I don't know everything. You see, the work that my parents do each and every day, that's real work. The work that I get the privilege of doing, that's not hard work. The hardships and struggles that my parents are faced with each and every day, and the many parents in this crowd, that's real work. I'm returning right now from New Mexico, which is hometown, because my father fell off a 15-foot ladder working in construction. Thank God he's okay, but he completely crushed his foot, and it was really difficult to see. I came back, and just before I headed over to you guys, I was at the White House. Look, you all, the life that I get to live is not one that was created for people like me. I grew up with parents who would pick up boxes outside of churches, with food and clothing, outside of Goodwill. And I respect that. And we should always acknowledge it. Because they brought us here, and many of our parents are trying to be supportive, and families day in and day out. And those that may not have those family structures, you have other communities that are there for you. You see, I believe there is a greater good. And even though some people may call me a little too optimistic sometimes, I could care less. Because guess what? Being optimistic gave me hope. And having hope gave me courage. But that courage always needs to be tied in with my values. So, you know how your friends just played the whole song right here? How many of you guys like music? Raise your hand. I know you all do like music. All right. Okay. So, grounding. When I speak of grounding, when I go to places, especially in D.C., because mind you, I moved from New Mexico to Washington to get this political appointment, right? There's times when I go to the White House, y'all. Let me tell you. I'm just going to tell you this. And right before I enter, I listen to really loud Mexican music on purpose. I know. I'm sorry. Ya sé. No me pongan porque... No me pongan. I do it on purpose. Because I come out and then I'm all tears. Because my parents cannot enter that White House. Because until today, my parents are undocumented. And it's hard to have so much privilege that I cannot hand over. Optimism has been a mode of survival for me, and for many of you. But you all have the ability to literally change the world. You have the ability to change the lives and the communities that you represent. And I want to ask you that when you're at the table and when you have the ability to speak, I want you to take it. But I don't want you to take it just to take up space and be cool, because then it's not cool. But rather, raise your voice with consciousness to remind you that regardless of what you accomplish, the greatest accomplishments will only flourish as long as you remember your roots, where you were initially planted and who helped you grow. Gather the strength to create crops to share with the ones coming right behind. So, as I told you, our motivations, our values, the people who inspire you, think of them. And think of them often. How many of you have some of those individuals here today? Raise your hand. Those people who inspired you and who pushed you and who helped you. All right, raise your hand. They're watching you. You see, I have a name for these people. So let me just share it with them. I call these people positive interrupters. And we all have them. And I'm willing to bet that a whole lot of them are here. So I have four asks for you, graduates. My first ask is to stay grounded and to flourish with pride and strength by uplifting your roots. My second ask is to believe in yourself regardless of what the world tells you or what they expect from you. Be grateful and challenge yourself to regularly give thanks to those who have impacted your life, because in the blink of an eye, those people could be gone. Hold your people accountable. The people who offer you support and help, hold them accountable. If I'm standing here, I'm not standing here just to talk. I've lived it, and I'm not claiming that I have lived your lives and struggles and difficulties, but I have lived my own. And I'm always willing to help and support in any way that I can. So follow me on social media and do whatever you want and reach out. And believe me, I will answer. Hold on. And then, I want to reassure that you guys understand the fact that you are all positive interrupters for the generations that are coming after you. But I want to hear it from you. So can we agree? Are you positive interrupters? Yes. Okay, so I need the graduates to stand up now. We're going to do it. Stand up. We're going to do this. Yep. Una, dos, tres, cuatro, cinco. I'll keep counting. All right. Graduates, if you hear me, clap once. Oh my God, that was so weak. Graduates, if you hear me, clap once. Clap twice. Three times. You guys need some vitamins. Did you not eat? Okay, all right. So, right now, again, we're gonna do this, we're gonna practice first. So at the count of three, I want you all to say, I am a positive interrupter. At the count of three, this is a practice. This is, you're gonna take it down for yourself. One, two, three. I am a positive interrupter. Good Lord, help you. Okay. Por bueno, la segunda. Now you're gonna look to the person behind you and you're gonna scream at them and tell them, I am a positive interrupter. One, two, three. I am. Oh Lord, you guys. Okay. What? This is the last one. Together, parents, family, staff, help us. If you wouldn't mind standing up, if you can. At the count of three. One, two, three. I am. Gracias. Thank you all.
I know the mic's on, okay? We truly appreciate all of our teachers and want to thank all of them for all of their support and guidance over the years. The senior class voted on the most inspirational teacher. It was a very difficult decision because so many deserve a recognition. After a close vote, the teacher who received that award this year, can I get a drum roll real fast? Y'all got sticks on you? Can I get a drum roll? Yeah, thank you very much. All right, drum roll please. The teacher is Miss Lucia Applequist. I guess so. Thank you for being inspiration.
Class of 2023 has excelled in many areas and has been awarded scholarships and other honors. It is with great honor that I would like to introduce Dr. Brenda Elliott, Chief of School Improvement and Supports, who will present the Valedictorian and Salutatorian Awards. Following Dr. Elliott, some of our faculty members will present special awards. Please welcome Dr. Brenda Elliott.
And you've heard from these wonderful young people quite a bit today. I would like to invite Juliana Lopez Aguilar to the here, please, to receive the award for valedictorian. And Andrew Douglas Mason for the award for salutatorian.
The next award we'd like to present is the Principal's Achievement Award, and this is awarded to a student who not only has academic achievement, but service to the school and to the community. And the award this year goes to Jennifer Ayala Guzman.
Thank you.
To all my positive interrupters and all my hall walkers, this next award is for a person that has demonstrated that they have the capacity to be an excellent scholar. They lead by example, and they are absolutely wonderful. I'm going to try to say this in Spanish. Please forgive me if I mess up. Este reconocimiento es para una persona que siempre está intentando, siempre está mejorando, y siempre está el ejemplo para los otros estudiantes. So, how was that? Was that all right? So, without further ado, please give a round of applause for one, Isaac Fuentes.
Good afternoon, everyone. First, shout out to all the families who came out. You guys showed out a lot of love. I mean, look behind you, graduates. It's more people here than a Mystics game. So you guys are doing your thing. Shout out to the families. I'm going to give out the Citizenship Award. This award goes to a student who is not only a leader in the school, but also in the community. Catherine Chavez Arevalo. Come on up. That's right, take your time. It's okay, take your time.
Good afternoon, congratulations. You're very welcome. I have the pleasure of announcing the most improved student. This student worked hard to recover the needed credits without hesitation, without complaint. He is attending the Southern University at AMM College with a $180,000 scholarship. The most improved student goes to Nemuel Danga.
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Wendy Pugh, and I am the director of the NAF Academy, and I'm here to present the Career and Technical Education Award to a student who has worked very hard in the field of information technology. He's also a gifted artist and will be attending American University on a full scholarship. This award goes to Mr. Timothy Williams.
Congratulations, class of 2023. I'm so proud of you all. Y'all made it. Good job. Good job. I am here today to present the Exceptional English Language Learner Award. This young lady is very hardworking. She's pleasant. She excels in all of her AP classes. Very quiet, easygoing, going to college. Great student to check. Her name is Yasmin Leon Flores.
Class of 2023, this is the last time you hear this. This is your 3101 Czech Sports News on the FM dial. Heading to Pennsylvania on a football scholarship to Shippensburg University, standing at 6'6", 240 pounds, Mr. Quiet, Mr. Humble, no other than TJR Harrison. This is the Student Award of Athletics.
Congratulations to class of 2023. I'm so proud of each and every one of you. My name is Mandy McCulloch, and I'm the chair of the Visual Arts Department, and I'm here to present a very special award to an outstanding photographer and storyteller, Mr. Jonathan Gerald.
Well, my name is Jacqueline Villalpando. I'm very excited and to be here with all your students. Voy a presentar esta tarde. Yo, primeramente, buenas tardes. Soy la señora Villalpando Strickland y soy la maestra y formadora de maestros que va a presentar los premios del sello de ser bilingüe. So today I'm going to present the awards and for the seal of the biliteracy. Seal to be a positive interrupter and do it in more, two or more languages. The students are, los alumnos con este sello de conocimiento ser bilingüe son Kelvin Cruz Parada, Bonnie Delgadillo, Jasmine León Flores, Mauricio Solórzano, Juliana López Aguilar. Si se pueden quedar aquí al frente, if you can just stay here all at on the stage, please. Michael Olivares Cruz. Por favor, quédense aquí on stage. Please stay on stage. Héctor Ruiz Salmerón. Esta es nuestra herencia y orgullo. This is our proud heritage of having two languages or more languages as a seal of biliteracy that appears on the transcript. Estos son nuestros positive interrupters. Y por los sacrificios de nuestras familias, gracias. Thank you for your sacrifices. We love you very much.
Good afternoon. As a member of the Blueprint College and Career Team, allow me to say congratulations to you all for overcoming and conquering so many things that were designed to take you out, but you did not let it. Your resiliency is unmatched. For the past 38 years, Bell Multicultural High School has been awarding graduating seniors with post-secondary scholarships for all their hard work and dedication to not only your school, but to your family and community, and this year is no different. For demonstrating excellence in academic achievement, outstanding student involvement, and the promise of great things to come, Bell Multicultural High School at Columbia Heights Education Campus would like to recognize the following Bell Scholarship recipients: Glenda Vasquez, Katherine Ayala, Journey Bolden, Treasure Sly.
The next students who were awarded scholarships last night are Isaac Fuentes, Kaylin Guandique, and Henry Gualit.
The following students were also awarded: Rosalina Martinez Romero, Shalur Monk, Edwitt Denicki.
I'd also like to recognize Circlem Asfawu, Dorico Austin, Jennifer Ayala, and Tasia Sly.
All right, Leslie Castillo, y'all come on up now. Catherine Chavez, Bonnie Delgadillo, and Caleb Stige.
Congratulations, class of 2023. I will miss you. I love you all. I'd like to call Elias Sharp. Veronica Miller. And Andrew Mason.
All right. The prestigious Bell Scholarship also goes to the following students:
Josue Israel Ibarra. Dionis Martinez. Noe Santiago Martinez. And Kidis Bisonet.
Okay, class of 2023, this is the moment you've been waiting for. You are getting ready to walk across this stage into the rest of your life. And we know the world is in good hands. Remember, you will always have a home at Columbia High's educational campus. This is not goodbye, this is hasta la vista. So as you come across the stage, remember, after you shake hands, to move your tassel from the right to the left. And at this time, I would like to present the class of 2023 to Dr. Brenda Elliott. If all members of the class could please stand. Are we ready? If we can bring everyone to attention. By the power vested in me by the District of Columbia Public Schools and the Mayor of the District of Columbia, I hereby present the class of 2023 of Columbia Heights Educational Campus and certify that they have completed all requirements for graduation from the District of Columbia Public Schools.
On behalf of Chancellor Louis Farabee and the District of Columbia Public Schools, I accept the class of 2023 as graduates of the District of Columbia Public Schools.
Congratulations, and now we will begin deferring the diplomas.
Juliana Lopez Aguilar. Andrew Mason. Isaac Fuentes. Catherine Ayala. Jennifer Ayala Guzman. Luna Burhani. Almira Simone Carter. Erlawit Denike. Kanice Keturah Garnett. Perla Guzman. Kaylin Guandike. Jasmine Holly.
Josue Ibarra. Yasmin Leon Flores. Jahi Lopez. McKenna Macran. Rosalinda Martinez Romero. Nancy Molina Ortiz. Jeremiah Ogunsi-Aiken. Sara Romero Chavez. Hector Ruiz Salmar. Elias Sharp. Dylan Skihan. Glenda Vasquez. Timothy Williams. Benicia Zuma. Ana Aguilera. Jared Alberto Turcios. Jocelyn Ardone Ramos. Calvin Armstrong. Sir Kalim Asfawu. Derrico Zaire Austin. Zariah Bailey. Elder Barahona. Khalil Barksdale. Kyrie Beeman. Kaya Bell. Herson Benavides Andrade. Giovanni Alvarenga. Mauricio Amaya. Jessica Fosaga. George Amaya. Edwin Aragon Aguilar. Javon Murray. Michael Carter. Christian Salvador. Charlie Cabrera Rivera. Kaylin Canales Guardado. Maricel Carino. Ariana Carson.
Leslie Castillo. Catherine Chavez Arevalo. Javier Chavez. Jeba Chemeda. Michaela Colvin. Jeremiah Conti. Jayshon Cooks. Alejandra Cortez Torres. Catherine Cruz Galeas. Cindy Cruz Mazariegos. Kelvin Cruz Parada. Edwin Cuevas Garcia. Lanea Daniels. Jacqueline Bermejo. Kittis Bizuna. Journey Bolden. Catherine Bonilla. Iyasu Bulcha. Davon Britt. Davon Brooks. Darren D. Money Brooks. Christian E. Brown. Diamond Brown. Kaija Brown. Ricardo Flores Lazaro. Carlos Flores.
You want Isaiah?
Isaiah Flores. Kelly Flores.
Your people made it.
Trevor Foskey. Jonathan Gerald. Maya Gomez Miranda. Henry Wallet Moran. Dina Gutierrez. Tyler Green. Jackson Guzman Martinez.
Hadera. Hadera.
Nathaniel Hadera.
Lord, put your phone away. Take your phone.
Diamond Hale.
Jefferson Hernandez.
You want Hernandez or Hernandez? You want the H pronounced?
Francisco Hernandez Pineda.
You want the H pronounced? Hernandez Hernandez.
Cindy Hernandez Andrade.
You want the H pronounced? Hernandez? Gisela or Gisela?
Gisela Hernandez Benitez. Warren Hale Jr. Malia Daniel. Muhammad Daniels. Bonnie Delgadillo. Hadi Demisi. Donnie Dixon. Dennis Escobar. Catherine Estrella. Nadira Everett. Daniel Fajardo Castro. Christopher Jones. Lucia Gonzalez. Dante Keys.
Brother Muhammad.
Muhammad. Concobo Jr. John Lemos. Janiah Liverpool. Johan Lopez Garcia. Claudia Machado. Edwin Marcelo Lopez. Dionis Martinez. Cynthia Martinez Cardoso. Brian Martinez Santos. Darwin Mejia. Larson Mejia. Diana Mendez Argueta. Milton Merlos Luna. Veronica Miller. Shalor Monk.
Get over here. Come here.
Unique Montgomery. Julian Hardy. Latavius, number five, Harley.
T.R.J. Harrison. Marcel Hill. Jermaine Holloman. Dwayne Houston. Amilcar Iraeta Mendoza. Cindy Izaguirre. Samantha Jimenez. Gladys Giron. Nelson Marquez. Junior Marroquin. Demisha Patton. Chester Pearson Jr. Amy Perez Castro. Francesca Perez Urbaez. Maria Perez Perez. Mikai Pearson. Kevin Ramirez Sanchez. Jeremy Reyes. Cesar Rosales. Eliman Sum.
Derek, you don't want the whole name? Is it Derek Sam? What you want? Say what you want.
All right. Derek Samuel. Noe Santiago Martinez. Janaya Short. Tasia Sly. Treasure Sly. Ayana Smallwood. Rayana Smith. Maylin Morales Chavarria. Jennifer Moreno. Elizabeth Munoz Casarubias. Nemuel Dunga. Michael Olivares Cruz.
You want David or David?
David. David. David Oriana. Eliana Orena Miranda. Jacqueline Otero Portillo. Eduardo Pacheco. Jason Pace. Adonis Ramos Iglesias. Brandon Ramos Martinez.
What's up, Mr. Reed?
Anton Reed. India Roberson. Tar 62 Timus. Haida Urquilla. Jordan Viagres Lopez. Alonzo Villatoro. Jaden Vincent. Zariana Whitaker. Isler Romero. Maxi Song. Mauricio Sorozano. D'Amico Suggs. Zion Suggs. Tanea Summers. Tanea Summers. Taka Thomas. Tarnell Thomas. Royette Tendugan. Tajay Turner. Shanae Williams. Mikel Wilson. Purcell Wood the fourth. Ayana Bangura. Ananaya Yared. Catherine Chavez Cruz. Caleb Teske. Y la última, Flor Amaya.
Okay, class of 2023, make sure you moved your tassel from right to left. And if now, present the class of 2023. Okay, you did it, you did it, you did it. Congratulations. So the class of 2023 can please stand. We're gonna get ready for the recessional. And the class is gonna exit this way, so we ask everyone to remain seated until the class of 2023 has exited the building. So at this time, we are ready for our recessional. Going out, high school graduates. Everybody ready? If we can stand and get ready to do the recessional. Follow the exit sign.
I need to get my granddaughter from the airport. So
thank you so much.